Hi guys, Codetutor here and my name is Anil Deshpande.
We ended the previous video on the note that with this code we have implemented first part of the implementation where our activity can connect to the service. Now the remaining part is the service responding back with the random number and activity receiving it and displaying it back to the UI. Picking it from there,
once the service receives message, it will process that particular message and now it needs to reply back to the requester who had requested for the random number. It needs to know from where the request had come. So in simple terms, we need to set from address also when we are sending the message. For that, we will create another messenger in application which is requesting for the random number. This messenger will have a reference to a handler. What this handler will basically do is, on receipt of message from the service, it will process it, set the value, whatever the random number that it had received from the service, to the activity. So when we are sending the message, we need to set the messenger and handler into the message. If you remember correctly, we had used an attribute called reply to. We need to set this messenger, which in turn has reference to the handler, to the reply to attribute of the message. After setting it, it will reply back through the messenger that we have set in the reply to attribute of the message, and in this way the random number will be channeled to the messenger and then in turn to the handler, and finally the value will be set to the activity. So this is how the whole request and response from application which wants to remotely connect to a service and from the service to the application which had requested for the connection is going to complete the whole cycle. Now we will go through a code which explains this in a technical way. So you can see that I have created a class called as receive random number handler extends handler. As you extend the handler, you have to override the handle message method. It has a message argument. The implementation details is, I will be initially setting the random number value to 0. The message that we receive, it will be having a value called what. I am comparing it with a flag, get random number flag. In the previous video, I had used get count, which didn't make much sense. So I have renamed that particular flag with get random number flag. And if this flag exists in the message, that means that message contains random number. So in the service, I'll be setting the random number to the argument 1. I'll be fetching the random number from the argument 1. And I will set that particular random number to the text view. If you go back here in line number 28, I have created two messengers. That is random number request messenger and random number receive messenger. Random number receive messenger will be used to handle the received message from the service. This handler, receive random number handler, is used by the random number receive messenger. So in the onService connected method of the random service connection, you will see that I am initializing random number receive messenger. And as I had told earlier, this messenger will be initialized with the receive random number handler. That is basically this particular class, which is going to process the received message and set the random number to the text view. Now, the another method is onService disconnected. I am just initializing both the messengers to the null. The final implementation is fetch random number, which will be triggered whenever I click on the get random number button. The overall idea in this particular method is, if the service is bound, then only we should send the request to fetch the number. Otherwise, we should just toast a message that service is unbound and can't get the random number as a toast message. And if the service is bound, you need to set the from address to the message. So you create a message, message.obtain with the flag will give you a message object. You use that message object's reply to attribute and set messenger. This particular random number receive messenger internally contains reference to a handler which is going to handle the received message, fetch the random number and set it to the activity. After setting reply to attribute, we need to finally send the request to fetch the random number. For that, we will use the random number request messenger and send the message. Before we run this particular code, the service that we have in the other app needs to be exported. We need to set an attribute called exported equals to true. So this is Android security feature, that a service which doesn't have its attribute exported set equals to true cannot be accessed from another app. Let us run this particular code and see what happens. Let me run the service first. I will click on the start service and you can see that the random numbers are getting generated and being displayed in the logcat, and the stop service will basically stop that particular service. Let me run other app, which is basically the client app, which will try to connect to this particular service. So you can see that my client side binder app has also started. Let me hit the get random number. You can remember that my service is still not yet started. You can see that service is unbound, can't get the random number. Makes sense. I will hit the bind service button. So you can see that the service got bound. My service has still not started. And if I try to get the random number, I should get 0 as the value. Now I will go to the other app and start the service. Open the other app and start service. So service has started. So definitely the random number will not be 0. So let me go back to the other app and hit the get random number. And you can see that now we are getting some random numbers. And if I go back to the previous app, which is a service app, and try to hit stop service, you can see that the service is not getting stopped. To confirm that whether service has stopped or not, you can go back to the client side binder app and hit the get random number again. If it gives me 0, that means the service has stopped. If it gives me some number, that means the service has not yet stopped. So you can see that the service has not yet stopped in spite of hitting the stop service button, because a bound service cannot be stopped. And now if I hit the unbind service, you will actually see two toast messages. The first one is the service unbound and the second one is service stopped, because as soon as the service gets unbound, it will automatically get stopped because we had hit stop service earlier. So let me hit the unbind. So you can see the service stopped and you will see also service unbound both. So whatever the discussions that we had in the local binding about a service behavior still hold true even for the remote binding. That brings us to the end of this particular video and end of this particular series as well. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe and comment. Take care. Bye.